Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let's take a look at creating a basic presentation in Keynote. So I'm using Keynote version 6. Let's look at how to create a standard slideshow. So when you start off, you first get asked to choose a basic theme. And you have two options here, go to standard or wide. So if you're presenting on a wide screen like modern television, you're going to want to do wide. But for old-fashioned business presentations, you'll just want to stick with standard 4x3. So let's use that, and you can scroll through and pick out a theme here. But for our purposes, let's choose something pretty simple like this gradient theme. So you'll always be given one example slide here, and you can just double-click in any text box here on a slide to enter in text. To add another slide, you simply go to the plus button here in the bottom left, click it, and you get shown a bunch of templates for slides that you can use. You could start off with a completely blank slide, or you could use something that already has things in it. These will change depending upon which theme you chose. So let's just choose one that has an image like this one, and it will add itself here. Now we see two slides. You can change the view here on the left to have the navigator here like this. We could get rid of the navigator. We can do a light table to show us which slides are there and double click to jump to it. Or we can do an outline of all the slides. Probably the most useful is just the navigator here. It allows you to do just about everything. And we can click on a slide to jump to it. And then we can edit what's in there. We can also use the zoom here to zoom out. So let's shrink that a bit so we can see the entire slide. Let's do it even more here. So there we go. So now it's easy for us to edit this. And we can type some text. And now we want to put an image here. So to get an image here, we want to click the little button here that allows us to grab something from our photo library. We can also drag and drop from the Finder over this image right in there. But let's just select something from there, and now we've got that photo placed in there. If we double click on any image, we can change its cropping here and do change its size if we wanted to by using switching between these two buttons and these two different modes. So you can adjust an image like that. You also, in the format area over here, if you don't see that, press format here, you can change the style. So you can add a border around the image if you want. You can do a shadow reflection. You can use one of the preset styles that's here like that. We can also go into image and change a bunch of different things about it, like for instance, you know, enhance it or change its exposure or some other things with colors. And we can even rotate the image here. We go to arrange, and there's different things we can do to align it, and also manually set its size, position, rotation, and even lock it if we don't want it to be editable anymore on the slide. Now, for the ultimate versatility, you want to add a blank slide like that one right there, which just gives you the background. And in here we can add a variety of different elements. For instance, I can add a text element right here and just select one, and then I can move this around, enter in text, and in the when I select it in the format bar, I've got style for the box, and then I've got things like font size over here under text, so I can put this anywhere I want. I could add a shape, and I could set its style and all sorts of different properties for it. I could add media, so I can add another photo. And then I can shrink the photo down and make it fit in place there. I can add a chart, I can add a table. So there's a lot of different things that I could do with just this. I can even just use the shapes to add basic arrows and things like that. As you're working on your presentation, you may need to rearrange things. You can drag and drop these thumbnails on the left like that. You can even group them underneath by dragging kind of a little bit to the right, so now that slide is now grouped under there. You can select multiple slides and drag them around. So there's a lot of different things that you could do here just by rearranging these slides. It's also very useful to set a slide to skip. So I can control click on a slide here and say skip, and you can see it shrinks it down. So that's useful if you've got a long presentation and you want to give a short version of it. You can set a bunch of different slides to skip just before you give the presentation. And now when you want to play, you simply hit the play button here. It'll fill the screen, and then I'm going to just use a spacebar to advance. You can see it'll jump from 1 to 3 like there. I use the escape key to escape out of it, and I can turn the skipping off. You could also use the format bar over here when you have instead of an object selected, you just select the background, and now you can kind of revert this to one of the basic templates there, and you can also add some basic elements. Also, you could set the background here, so there's a lot you can do to just bring an image in or set a gradient or something else, like take the fill away completely or set it to a solid color. So you're not just stuck with the same background over all the slides. So there's a look at some of the basics to get you started in creating presentations in Keynote.